sit down, let's celebrate this love we found. Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, making home and entertaining simple. Today is the first video of my four-part series, Simple Organizing Ideas, Three Tips for an Organized Freezer. So I've had this freezer for 13 years now. It's a side-by-side stainless steel fingerprintless, and it has not broken down. The only thing that has been broken is the ice maker, so we just buy a bag of ice every week and fill that up. I thought a good way to show you my freezer is to just give you a tour of the different shelves and show you what's in here. I do like to put all of the stuff that we buy from the grocery store into containers as much as possible. Of course, not all of them are in containers. Example, like these packs of potatoes or some of the veggies. I like putting them in containers because they do look uniform and therefore the space looks neater. My first tip is out with the old. Throw out the expired food, the food you no longer eat because of diet restrictions or you are now making different food choices, the meat or meals you threw in the freezer but didn't label and now there's freezer burn or you have no idea what it is. Example, I had a can of frozen orange juice. It expired over a year ago. But I kept thinking that I'm going to drink it because I didn't want to waste the 89 cents that it cost me to get that can. But no one drinks frozen orange juice in my family. I finally threw it away when I saw the expiration date. Number two is organize according to your lifestyle. Our diets change either by choice or need. Sometimes we become gluten-free or meatless, or we use a lot of smoothies for breakfast versus cereal. Or maybe you're a mom who works outside of the home, so you need to prepare more freezer meals. Or maybe it's summertime and we eat more ice cream. For example, my family is eating less meat. In fact, two of my family members haven't eaten meat for about 8 months now. So we need a larger space and a dedicated shelf for things like veggie burgers, veggie bites, meatless chicken patties. These are things that I don't make from scratch, but there are frozen options from the grocery store, so I needed a space just for those items. Also, I used to have two shelves for meat, one for chicken and one for beef and pork. Now I have just the one drawer at the bottom for all the types of meat. I used to even be part of an organic meat co-op, so there were times during the year where my freezer was completely filled with meat, but since that's changed, I changed the system accordingly. I also have a shelf dedicated to smoothie packs that I prepare in advance. I pack these in one sitting for the whole week, and it makes it easier to grab them in the morning. My last tip is to label the uncharted territory. Uncharted means not yet surveyed or investigated, unexplored. Since the freezer is an area in our kitchen that is not necessarily used by every family member every day, not like the refrigerator or the pantry or silverware drawer, it is helpful to label every shelf and sections of the door so that after a grocery haul, it's easy to put things where they belong, or when you're doing your list for the groceries, you know what needs to be replenished. Since you made it almost to the end of the video, I wanted to share this hack that I just came up with. It is a bamboo cutting board that I'm using as a shelf. It sits on the drawer, and I just have some egg rolls, wonton wrappers, and banana leaves on here. So those are my three tips for an organized freezer. Number one, out with the old. Tip number two, organize according to your lifestyle. And tip number three, label the uncharted territory. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please join me on this journey to making home and entertaining simple by hitting that subscribe button. I'd love for you to leave a comment below and let us know what is your tip for an organized freezer. I think it's great to learn from each other, and I do love reading your comments. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!